Hi, I'm Rob D. I'm here with Rob B. We're from Property Hub, and this is the Property Hub University course on how to win big at off-plan property without losing your shirt. Off-plan property is one of those topics that's really divisive. Some people will tell you should avoid it like the plague. Others will say that that's the only way to really make money in property. Truth is, there are some fantastic opportunities, but you do need to be aware of the downsides. So this course is all about making sure that you're educated so you can take advantage of the opportunities without exposing yourself to the risks.
So let's have a look at what we're going to cover. We're going to have a look at the off-plan buying process, how it works, and why developers offer it in the first place. We're going to look at the benefits of buying off-plan, including the huge leverage advantage that you may have. We're also going to check out how to protect yourself and avoid those horror stories that often make the press. We'll also help you decide if it's the right time to buy off-plan and help you avoid when it definitely is not. And we'll wrap up by giving you the essential rules for off-plan success.
So let's start at the very beginning. Off-plan is a term that's often thrown around, but what does it actually mean? Well, all it means really to buy off-plan is to buy a property before construction is complete. So construction may be well underway and it's not that far away from completion, or it may not have started yet at all. As a result, the off-plan period can really span a long amount of time. It can just be months or it can be years. We'll come to why you might want to do this, but it's worth understanding why the phenomenon of off-plan exists. Why is this something that developers offer? Well, developers sell off-plan for three reasons. They do it to help their cash flow so they can get some money in. They do it so they can de-risk the later stages of the build because they've already completed and sold some before they've got to that stage, especially for bigger projects. And they also do it to demonstrate to other buyers that they're a demand. If they can show that a large proportion of them have been sold before it's even completed, then by the time they do get to completion, or by the time they get to later phases, other buyers are far more likely to buy and buy at higher prices because they feel more secure doing so, knowing that other buyers have already committed and that this is a development that's in demand and they can't hang around, otherwise they'll miss out.
So how does the off-plan buying process work? Well, normally it follows a simple process. You pay a reservation deposit to secure the property. This can vary. It may be £1,000, it may be £2,000, and in some cases it may be £5,000. This reservation deposit will normally be deducted from the deposit you pay on exchange. And when you exchange, you pay that deposit. It's often 10%, but you may see it higher. It may be 20, 30, 40, 50%. So don't just assume it's 10%. Make sure you check. And you will pay this at the point of exchanging contracts, which is normally around 28 days after reservation. And once you've paid it, you're committed to the purchase. Now, when construction is complete, the developer will serve notice to complete. And that's when you have to make sure that the rest of your funds are ready. People will often use a mortgage at this point. You may be buying cash, but if you're using a mortgage, you would have got that in order a few months previously. And finally, you'll do a bit of snagging, which is just checking the property over and collect the keys. The property is now yours.
Now, cement your learning by taking the quiz. Then we'll move on to the next module.
So, why would you want to buy property off plan? Let's take a look.
Well, the first reason is that you get a brand new property. Nobody's lived in it before, it's in perfect condition, and you know that there's nothing wrong with it. And just in case there is anything wrong with it, if anything happens in the first 10 years, it's normally protected by guarantee. So you've got a property that's brand new, it's very attractive to tenants, and you've limited your downside because you've got those guarantees in place.
Another big reason to consider off-plan is that you can get a discount compared to when they're finished. So because the developer is keen to get some off-plan sales away, they may be willing to do a discount. Now, it's not a given, so make sure you do your research to make sure it is a genuine discount, but it certainly is possible.
And the final reason is probably the biggest, or at least it can be. And that is that in a rising market, you could really benefit from the extra leverage that buying off-plan gives you. What does this mean? Well, it's such an important point that it's worth going into this in a bit more detail and looking at an example.
So off-plan leverage, let's have a look. What does it mean? Let's say you agree a purchase price of £100,000 and you have a low deposit of just 10% when you reserve and exchange. And that deposit therefore would be £10,000. Now, if the off-plan period was 2 years, and the market just grew 5% a year during that period, then the property value on completion would be £110,250, an increase of £10,250. Fantastic. Which means that you've doubled your money during that period of time. Your deposit of 10% has secured you a gain of £10,250. Or looking at it another way, over 100% return on investment. It's not very often you see returns like that.
This takes a bit of getting your head round at first, and you might want to pause the video here and make sure that you take this in, because it sounds a bit too good to be true, and it often takes people a little while to understand it, but it is completely true. What you could do, and what a lot of people have done historically, is actually sell the property on just before the point of completion, so you never end up actually buying the property. You effectively flip it on. So you benefit from making that 100% gain, which can be into the five figures, as we've seen, without ever actually owning the property. But it doesn't matter whether you do or not. Even if you hold on to the property and you add it to your portfolio, the effect is exactly the same. You've only put down £10,000 to bag yourself more than £10,000 increase in equity. So you can see why, in a rising market, the benefits of buying off plan can be absolutely huge.
Now cement your learning by taking a quiz. Then we'll move on to the next module.
Let's take a look at the dangers of buying property off plan. If you've ever opened a newspaper, you will have seen horror stories about buying off plan. So let's break down the different things that can go wrong so we can then figure out how to protect ourselves against them.
So the market might fall. If the market falls, so the price of your property is worth less between the point of exchange and completion, you're still committed to buying a property and you may be purchasing it for more than it's actually worth.
The second danger is that you might not be able to get finance on the property, especially if it's a long off-plan period, say a couple of years. The mortgage market can change in that time. So it could be the case that by the time completion happens, either the market has changed or your personal circumstances have changed, and you might not be able to get a mortgage at the same attractive rates you can now, or in extreme circumstances, you might not be able to get a mortgage at all.
Another danger you need to be aware of is the developer might go bust. Yes, the developer that you've purchased through and have a contract with may not be able to deliver, and they may not be able to build that property for you. And if they go bust before completion, then it's possible you might lose your deposit in full. So this all sounds scary stuff, and it can be, but in the next video, we're going to look at how you can protect yourself.
Now, cement your learning by taking the quiz. Then we'll move on to the next module. How do you protect yourself when you're buying property off plan? There are some big advantages to buying off plan, but you want to make sure that you do it safely and position yourself to reap the rewards without taking unnecessary risks. So let's take a look at how to do that.
The first thing you want to do is make sure your deposit is protected. Now, a deposit should be held in escrow or protected by a guarantee. And what escrow is basically just a bank account where your money is held securely and can't be touched by the developer, even if they ask really nicely. A guarantee should be insurance backed. So NHBC, for example, who provide the warranty for many new build homes, also protect your deposit up to 10%. So if the developer goes bust, you're still covered. And remember, try not to put down more than 10% because the chances of it being protected beyond that point are reduced. And also be wary of using a solicitor that the developer recommends directly, because they may be pally with that developer and it may seem that the deposit is protected, but actually the protection may be a little weak. So you should be always checking that your deposit's held in escrow or protected by insurance through someone like the NHBC.
Next thing to do is research the developer. So having your money held in escrow or having it protected by a warranty is your backstop, but you don't want it to happen at all. You don't want the developer to get into trouble. So to give yourself confidence that they're going to be able to complete when they say they will, look into their track record. Take a look at their previous projects. The big national house builders you'll be aware of, and you can be pretty confident that they're going to be able to deliver. But there are plenty of other players who aren't household names. Some of them are extremely credible and have a strong track record. Others have just popped up overnight and you wouldn't necessarily want to take that risk. So look into what they've done before. This is where Google is your friend. Generally, if there's bad news out there, it will come up if you click through the first few pages. Hopefully, you'll just find lots of glowing reports about projects that they've completed. But if there's anything bad, you'll be able to sniff it out. For smaller builders, as well as looking up the name of the company, you can get the directors' names from Companies House and Google their names as well. It's very possible that if they are a dodgy operator, they might have an unsuccessful scheme, then pop up with a different company name for the next one to make sure that you can't find out what went before. But looking up the name of the director and seeing what companies they've been involved with and looking up the names of those companies is a way of getting around that risk. And if you want to take it a level deeper, you can even look up the company's financials. It's all freely available on Companies House, so you can see what their financial position looks like. The great thing is, none of this is very difficult or very time consuming. It's basic stuff. You don't need to put a whole day aside, but just by taking this step of doing the research, you'll be able to avoid the majority of bad situations that people get themselves into that can give Offplan a bad name.
The next way of protecting yourself is knowing your mortgage options. Don't commit to buying before you know you can get a mortgage. So you want to be discussing your options with a mortgage broker before you reserve. And be careful if that mortgage broker is only confident of providing you with a couple of options, because those options could disappear by the time of completion. Lenders come and go. Doesn't mean if they're here today, they could be here in a couple of years' time. It could also go in your favour and there'll be more options, but you don't want to gamble. Check with your broker that that particular development you're looking to buy on as well is mortgageable. It's great that you're checking if you're mortgageable and you have options available, but just make sure there's nothing wrong with that development and you'll be able to get a mortgage when completion comes around.
The next thing to do is to validate the discount. Often when a development is marketed, somewhere in the marketing material, it will make a claim about the level of discount that you're getting as a result of buying off plan. That can look very attractive. But don't take it at face value. Make your own judgment about the level of discount by checking what the price of the property should be when it's completed. So they might be saying that when it's complete, it's going to be selling for this amazing price, but you can look at what similar properties are worth nearby and see if that claim stacks up. If they're saying that you can get the property for $150,000, but when it's finished, it's going to be worth $200,000, then take a look at what sold recently and what's on the market right now. If you can't find anything of comparable size or quality or amenities selling for more than $160,000, then you'll know that that discount is just not true. So one of the big benefits of buying off plan is that you can get yourself a discount, but make sure that you're negotiating yourself a genuine discount by ignoring the discount claims of the developer and doing your own research. Again, it doesn't take long. Spend half an hour on Rightmove, pick up the phone to a couple of agents, and you'll quickly be able to tell if the numbers stack up or if they're being a little bit optimistic with the numbers they're quoting you.
Another thing you'll need to do when investing in off plan is avoid heated markets. So the ideal off-plan time is when the market is warm, but not red hot. If the market is exploding, it could crash before the project's complete. We've seen this before, and it will happen again. Luckily, it doesn't happen very often, but you have to be cautious. If the whole world is going property mad, and everybody's buying property left, right, and centre, then it's probably a bad time to invest. You may want to study market cycles and get to understand property a little better to give you confidence. And as part of Property Hub University, we have a course on this very subject. We take a look at the 18-year property cycle, which will give you confidence on when to invest and when to step away. Now cement your learning by taking a quiz. Then we'll move on to the next module.